In this example, we're going to solve mole balances for a packed bed catalytic reactor where we're going to use catalyst weight as the independent variable instead of reactor volume or reactor length. So we're given a gas phase hydrogenation reaction. It takes place over nickel catalyst. Now it's zero order in C and it's first order in the concentration of hydrogen. And the rate constant's given, and note the units are such to be consistent with the fact that we have the rate now per kilogram of catalyst. Feed is 2/3 hydrogen and 1/3 C, given temperature and pressure and its molar flow rate. Now we're going to assume the reactor is isothermal just to make the calculations easier to demonstrate the idea of solving the plug flow reactor with catalyst weight as an independent variable. And likewise, we're going to ignore the pressure drop. If there's a significant length to the reactor, then a packed bed reactor typically is going to have pressure drop, particularly if the catalyst particles are small. We're told how much catalyst in the reactor. We want plots of the flow rates of these three species as a function of the catalyst weight, namely as a function of the cumulative catalyst weight as we move down the reactor. So the first thing we're going to do is make a simple diagram to represent the process. So if hydrogen is C flowing in the reactor and then we have all three species leaving, the inlet reactor, we'll call this the weight of the catalyst equals zero, and the outlet is 4.8 kilograms. So what we're going to do is write down the mole balances, and we're going to write them for all three species. That's certainly the easiest way because we're going to solve this numerically to demonstrate the process that we would use for more complicated problems. The form of the mass balance is the change in the molar flow rate of C with respect to catalyst weight. And that's equal to the rate of reaction of C, which in this case is minus the rate constant times the pressure of hydrogen to the first power. The minus sign is because of the stoichiometry of the reaction. The reactants have minus, products have positive signs for stoichiometric coefficient. And then we're going to similarly write the mole balance for hydrogen, the rate of hydrogen, which is minus 2, same rate constant pressure of hydrogen. Finally, for the product, the change in the molar flow rate of M respect to catalyst weight is the rate of M, which is plus 1, rate constant pressure of hydrogen. Now these are initial value differential equations that we're solving, which means we need the initial values FC0, FH0, H2O, and FM0. Well, there's no M coming in, so this is 0. The feed total 40 moles, so 33% times 40 is the molar flow rate of C coming in, and 0.67 times 40 is the molar flow rate of hydrogen. To solve these equations, we need some additional information. Of course, we need the rate constant, and then we need to write the pressure of hydrogen in terms of molar flow rates so that we have sufficient equations to solve this. And so the pressure of hydrogen is the mole fraction of hydrogen times the total pressure. And the mole fraction is the molar flow rate of hydrogen over the total molar flow rate, which is hydrogen plus reactant C plus product M. And the pressure is 5 bar. So the pressure of hydrogen any point changes because of reaction, also changes because there's a mole change for this reaction. So to solve these equations, Then we're going to substitute into Polymath. And so I'll show the Polymath program and the output. So what I'm showing here is the Polymath program on the left side, where I have the differential equations, their initial conditions, the initial and final values for the catalyst weight, and then the calculation of the hydrogen partial pressure and the mole fraction of hydrogen. And then the output is going to show, this is the molar flow rate of the product, the molar flow rate of hydrogen, and the molar flow rate of the other reactant. And this shows how they change as a function of catalyst weight. So in this case, we get almost complete conversion for this amount of catalyst. And certainly, this is a simple problem that we don't necessarily need to solve numerically, but it demonstrates the procedure we would use in more complicated problems.